Have you ever wondered, what are bones made out of? Well, we will learn the answer to this and so much more with my rubber bone experiment. Hi, everyone. I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab your chicken bones because things are about to get weird. Emily's Science Lab. Stay curious. Bones are made up of a framework of soft and hard material. The soft material is made up of something called collagen. It's a protein that makes our bones a little bit flexible. The hard material is made up of something called calcium phosphate. This is what makes our bones strong. But as we get older, we start to lose some of this calcium, and that makes our bones weaker. That's why it's so important to eat foods that are rich in calcium and vitamin D, because vitamin D helps your bones absorb calcium. Here's what you need to make a rubber bone. Some chicken bones, clean them off with water and make sure that the only thing that is left is the bone. And here's a tip, the skinnier ones like this will work a little bit better for this experiment. A cup to place your chicken bones in, and some vinegar. You just need enough to cover the bones. So go ahead, cover your bones, just like that. And now we are going to let our bones sit for at least a week. The longer you let it sit, the better this will work. What is going to happen is your vinegar is going to react with the calcium phosphate, the hard part of the framework of your bone, and dissolve it, remove it, so that the only thing that is left is that softer collagen, making your bone a little bit flexible. So after a week, your bones will look like this. They don't look really any different to the naked eye. You can start to get a little bend in the bone. So it bends a little bit. That's after 7 days in vinegar. But now let's see what it looks like after 20 days. This is where things get really weird. Now look at this. Oh, look at that bone. Look how flexible our bone is. That vinegar has now dissolved most of that calcium phosphate away, and all that is left is your collagen. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Let's check our other bones. Oh, they're all so wiggly. Look at that. Are you kidding me? It's so weird. Ew. Okay, so this is what a larger bone will look like. A larger bone will take a little bit longer and it won't be as rubbery as those skinnier ones, but watch this. It's still quite flexible. Ooh, gosh, this one is not for the weak-hearted. I mean, that's a bone. Oh, this one's super rubbery.
Look how rubbery.
Thank you for making a rubber bone with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring books for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.